I saw a comedy special last night that was so good. I just have to share it with everybody. It was Club Piscopo. See, it's Joe Piscopo, and he's on stage, and he's got a big band behind him. Big band, you know, the old big band
Sure.
thing.
Oh, big band like Sinatra.
Right.
That shit.
And in
Perry
between
Como.
his hilarious, dead-on impersonations,
Oh, God, no.
he plays a bunch of instruments,
Oh, God.
Very mediocre.
Oh, God, no.
And it goes from flute to
Oh,
saxophone
God,
to
no.
guitar
No, no,
to
no.
All right, look. This could be the worst thing I've ever seen in my life on a television screen. It's so fucking bad. I can't even tell you. I was captivated by how awful it was.
Let's go get tickets.
Can we listen to this thing?
He is like, what? Is there any? Are there any clips from Club Piscopo?
Let's try this. I guess this is the big commercial for the
Hello, I'm Lou
thing.
Steiner, publisher of Atlantic City Weekly. Joe Piscopo was a member of the cast of Saturday Night Live from 1980 to 1985 and starred in Wise Guys and Johnny Dangerously.
Which he talks about in
Club
his stage
Piscopo,
show.
Right here at Resorts Casino in Atlantic City.
Nice.
Fly with me, let's fly, we'll fly away. If you can use some exotic clues, and there's a bar in Bob Bombay. Come on, fly with me, let's fly, we'll fly away.
He's doing an impression.
Come fly with me, let's float down to Peru.
He's so mediocre.
That's not even close to Sinatra.
No, no,
no. Is he trying to do Sinatra there?
Yes.
Oh, boy.
Yes. His impressions. And he was doing, like, Arnold impressions. I mean, come on. It's fucking 2012.
Yeah, a lot of the impressions you used to do, you don't do because they're not relevant anymore.
Nah, you throw them up as a goof. Like any Arnold impression now from me is just
right.
I'm Dick Bentley. How long are you gonna
oh
do it all
God.
Day?
Who enjoys
You're gonna do
that?
It all day.
Who enjoys
and then
that?
He was talking about he's like my mom.
Where's
oh
this
boy, she wanted me to play the piano, and she wanted me to play music like this. And then he gets behind the piano, and he starts playing like piano.
Well, where's that clip? That's the one we want to play today.
Oh, fuck yeah. That was on Showtime, though.
It was a Showtime
special. But he stopped going from an impersonation to act. Oh, no.
Oh, no.
I'll tell you about right now, the last week I was in rough shit. Now when the shark bites with his teeth, it's like scarlet billows. I gotta get knocked out of any more modest to make a house call. Now with the fancy white gloves, Maggie gets no respect. No respect at all. I'm alright, I'm okay. No respect at all. James Brown in the Denver Bank! Now I'm in the plane! With the seat that pad coming down, y'all!
Oh, this is so bad.
That's the madness of the week here.
Smattering. This is so fucking bad.
That doesn't sound like Sinatra.
No.
And he knows his Dangerfield sucks because he had to go with the no respect over and over again.
That's what an impression does
to remind people who he's doing.
Just the hits. I hate when an impression just does like the main lines.
Right.
Like, hey, I gotta call Dr. Vinny Boom Boss because he don't get no respect. How many Rodney things are you gonna mention in 2 seconds?
On the Garden State Parkway.
He's got
fucking ninth grade.
Do not close. Take the turnpike past exit 13.
Yeah.
Holding my nose.
Ah, get it?
Home run.
I can't take this. I'm douche chilling out.
This is fucking hilarious.
Yes. I'm getting goosebumps. He actually thinks.
Make it here. We're gonna make it. Anywhere it's up
what?
To you. NJ.
God.
That's great.
And then he pulls out a saxophone and starts like playing a saxophone. And he's serious. And then he does this fake, like he's like it's off the cuff, so he's laughing in the middle of his own jokes thing. I was fixated.
You got another clip, Danny?
Please. I can't get enough of why is it that I love bad shit like this?
I don't know. Look at the show you're on.
It just makes us feel better about ourselves.
Wait, was he laughing at his own jokes? Like he's having such fun while doing it?
He's like, but you know, and then he's saying literally stuff like this. He's going, and then I became friends with James Brown, and you know, for years I never understood a word he said. And he'd start laughing. He goes, James Brown.
Yeah.
Look, a fucking douche chilling out.
Yuck.
Here we go. And then I hear he was rapping. I missed the part where he was rapping. I didn't know this was his stage show. Atlantic City.
Watch out, Atlantic City.
Club Piscopo has arrived. Club Piscopo.
Not showing
is
them.
It?
They're not no, showing they're not any showing of his impressions.
Anything. No.
That has to say a lot.
Is that Father Guido Sarducci?
Yep.
He's part of Club Piscopo? Holy shit. Wow.
Is this show with Joe Frazier? How long ago is this?
Father Guido Sarducci. Jeff Norris.
Wait, the Jeff Norris?
Wait, Jeff Norris is part of...
Oh, Frankie Pace?
Victoria Jackson. Oh, no.
I wonder what impression Jeff Norris is going to do.
Oh, no.
JD from New York City. Look up Piscopo's song, Kimberly.
Yeah.
Was that about the babysitter?
Oh, probably. He did. He was talking about Schwarzenegger and saying that, at least my babysitter was pretty, which, you know.
Well, he married his babysitter, I think.
Yeah.
Oh, did he?
Yeah.
The title of this video is Prepare to Cringe.
Oh, is it?
I know we broadcast to most of the audience. It's actually
this is an old clip.
But I was going to do something for you tonight, and I'm going to ask you to stay with me. I wrote a song for Kimberly Driscoll, my fiance, right?
Oh, no.
And I got to tell you, I would never do this on, like, if it was like, you know, like a national HBO special or something like that. So I'm going to ask you, it's a straight song. There's no jokes. I know my mother likes it when I sing. So are you with me on this? Can we do a song for you, like a song?
Oh, no. Hold on to your fucking seats, kids.
What is this from?
What is this from?
I think we all just made the same face.
Yeah. Oh, my God. We all looked around at each other like, this isn't real. He's like, no jokes or anything. This is serious.
I need you to stay with me.
I need you to stay with
me. He knows it sucks. Doing? When you say that shit, you know it sucks already.
Jesus Christ.
What show is this on, Danny?
I don't know. There's no...
The shittiest show in the world.
Oh, my God.
I don't know. There's no details.
Dude, this... Oh, my God. He wrote a song for his fiance, which was his babysitter.
I think.
I think it is. Yeah.
Okay.
That he decided to plow. Mm-hmm. Oh, boy, dude, this could be really bad.
I need you to stay with me.
I need you to stay with me.
I hate when someone says, okay, if we do that, folks, it gets the cloud clap. Like,
yeah.
But that's not enthusiasm. That's just if giving you the support you've asked for.
Are you saying that's not a good start, Jimmy?
Unless I actually do that when I'm doing an animal fucking bit. I say, don't judge where this is going. I actually said that to Stella the other night. So I'm talking about fucking different animals.
Right. See, that's a little different than a song about your fiance. Could you rewind so we could get the intro into the song without any, because I want to hear this again.
I'd rather not.
Oh, please, this is great.
Also, the comment, the description for the video, rather, says, the epitome of self-indulgence, ego, and being under the unwavering influence of pussy. Truly inspiring.
Oh, God.
All right, hold on. Go grab something.
I wondered why Joe never ages. He's in that thing the whole time. Okay. I asked this audience is mostly from New Jersey, and again, I know we broadcast to most of the audience
Jersey
is actually
angle.
In New York.
Oh.
But I was going to do something for you tonight, and I'm going to ask you to stay with me. I wrote a song for Kimberly Driscoll, my fiance, right? And I got to tell you, I would never do this on, like, if it was like, you know, like a national HBO special or something like that. So I'm going to ask you, it's a straight song, there's no jokes. I know my mother likes it when I sing. So are you with me on this? Can we do a song for you, like a song?
Ah!
Oh, my God.
Sits at the piano.
This is for, I'm so hesitant to do it, but I feel at home.
No, you're not.
With family and friends. So this
There's
is
a piano there,
I'm
dummy.
Rock it with Iron
you're not hesitant.
Stay with me, guys. You set on this?
Stay with me.
Here we go.
Oh, no. Oh, God. Jimmy's cringing already. This is great. Oh, no! There's video clips of her.
I burn inside for you every day. I don't know what to do. Don't know what to say. You know I need you, girl. Desperately.
He's trying to be Bruce.
Oh, I need you. Kimberly.
Oh, my God, no!
Kimberly. 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 They say it's all wrong. We know it's all right.
Ah.
I love it so strong.
Oh, look, she's backstage looking at him lovingly. This is a joke.
When your daddy don't see.
If he turned this into a joke, it'd be great. Right?
We were meant to be.
Yeah.
If you had a reveal here, it'd be great. We're not gonna get the reveal, huh?
Just showing her in like fucking leotard exercise.
This is great. Kissing.
There's evil forces working here, girl. They're trying to pull us apart.
Why? Who?
Who's trying to? My love for you is clearing through. It's made from my heart. Oh, why don't they just let us be?
Oh.
You're a woman. I'm a man. Can you take my hand? Cover me. Cover me! Cover me!
Ah! I can't take this! This is so douchey!
This is going great! I'm sad for you! Don't know what to say! We're gonna make it, girl!
Oh. Did he think this is going to be a big hit?
I guess. The videos of the two of them are great.
I like how he said he was hesitant to even do this, and there's a giant band playing behind him.
Right.
It's all fucking arranged. And there's Kimberly. With a
hey,
she's got a
kick it, Ira, kick it for me, baby. They got a Kimberly
Why is
and
he?
Then he brings
and then he brings
Kimberly
her out.
Out. But he was hesitant to do this. It was on a whim. Oh.
Why would he bring his wife out on stage?
It's his fiance, and she's bowing, and she hands him flowers.
Yeah, give me the,
what year is this?
If I could just have highest sweetheart, that was from my bride to be. And I know you see us on Howard Stern. Howard, we love you. And I had to ask Kimberly.
Where has he been on Howard lately?
No kidding.
It's all right. I ought to ask Kimberly what she really. Here comes the handheld, baby. I want to talk to you. It's Channel 9. Stay with me, folks. Here we go. Thank you.
Oh, my God.
When we're on Howard, people always ask, and I wanted to do this on television. We're on Howard Stern. And you know how I feel. Does it bother you? Does it bother you when he's running after you and I'm pulling you off? This is what people always ask.
He's doing baby talk to her.
It's all in fun. It's just a big joke. And also, for the record, we did not get engaged on the Howard Stern show. He did it very romantically at home, and
why don't you tell the folks how I did it?
Well,
he's doing, dude, he's doing, but this is so.
On my birthday, and
I don't know. No one gives a fuck.
I'd be honored for you to be my wife, and I'd be honored to be your husband. And he got on one knee and he said, "Will you marry me, Kimberly?" It was beautiful.
Aw, that's nice.
What the fuck is this?
I don't know.
It's entertaining.
Thank you for letting me do that. You guys are very, very gracious. We'll be right back. Thank you.
Did he have a show or something?
Yeah, it's terrific. Kimberly! He's very soulful.
Why would he do that?
This is New York primetime.
Oh, wait, when he's back. Let's hear what he says when he's back. Oh, that was
Evan. Go back. Yeah, go back and see what it is. New York primetime. Prime? New York Prime?
New York Prime,
that
guess,
had to be
right?
Like 95.
I don't know.
I think it's
mullet.
Even longer.
That's before 95.
Dude, I think you're talking 92?
90,
maybe?
Mullets, early 90s.
Is he still married to that girl?
I have no idea. Probably not.
Kimberly!
No, I don't think they're together anymore.
I would say probably not.
They wanted to clear the record up.
That was so hard to watch.
If he had a reveal there and then it was a goof song, then he would have something.
Can you imagine if a chick
with a big setup?
A chick with a dick walked out.
right, yeah, something like that. Sure.
A chick with a dick or like an animal.
Yeah, yeah.
Then he would have something.
A fucking 8-year-old walks out.
Right.
Girl, you had me.
Kimberly, they're trying to break us apart. Who's trying to break you apart? No one gives a shit.
Exactly. People who like entertainment.
Who would try to break them apart?
Trying to make it sound like a big, like their love is getting through this big struggle.
Some of these guys, they lose touch with reality. Like, he really thought that would be a great segment for whatever show he's on.
Or
his show. I don't even know, man.
Dude. That was rough.
What year was that?
I want to know. Yeah, I do remember when he was on Stern a lot with Kimberly.
You do?
Yes, I do remember.
Hmm.
And I kind of remember them goofing on that very song. By the way.
All right. So what year?
It had
early '90s.
It had to be early '90s.
Okay.
Definitely.
So that could be 20 years old now. What we just saw.
Yeah, they're divorced. What happened? I wonder if they played that song in court.
You think he sings a different version of that song?
Oh, yeah. Cuntbrilly.
Right.
Oh, my God.
All right.
Well, she was his first kid's nanny when they met. Yeah.
Why would you allow your husband to have a fucking smoking hot nanny like that?
Because you're in love. Oh, God. That's how it's Stern Channel 9 show with
Kimberly, her 15th birthday today. That's right.
Her 15th birthday.
That's so beautiful. Yes. Joe, that's unbelievable. Now, you think this marriage will last, or do you think it'll last like the last? This is the right one. Well, what if you guys, if you have a kid together, Kimberly gets a little bit out of shape, and then a new babysitter comes over. Hey, I'm just warning you, Kimberly. You love another week in the pool. Kimberly, men are pigs. Remember that. And Joe's a man, so Joe's a pig. So I gotta tell you, Kimberly, whatever. You were in bed 3:30 in the morning, and I think you realize, like, this is like maybe the best thing that could ever happen. Did you? I gotta tell you.
Howard, everybody listening, and to everybody in L.A., to the William Morris agency, everybody who watches and say hi, because no one knows about this.
Right.
That Howard was, he was so instrumental in this, because we you know, we've known each other almost 10 years
He's so maudlin. He's maudlin.
What do you mean?
He's like, he's this cornball, fake sincerity, like, let me just be serious here for a minute. You know, he was instrumental in, like he's not joking.
Yeah, like, who cares? Where are the jokes? Like,
isn't it funny that Howard's goofing on Joe Piscopo with the tall, blonde, young girl?
No
and meanwhile, no what happened with Howard? No, it's exactly the same thing.
No kidding, man.
There's an article, by the way, from 2006.
Yeah.
And it's called, it begins, "The laughter has definitely gone out of Joe Piscopo's marriage." Now that the former Saturday Night Live star and wife Kimberly are divorcing.
2006, he made it to.
Hey. Yeah, Hunterston County Family Court judge issued temporary restraining orders.
Kimberly!
To both spouses on Monday after they were each alleged domestic abuse.
Wow. Isn't that amazing? You look at that.
Yeah, they're in
she's
love.
Bringing flowers out on the stage. He's introducing
he's
her.
He's blowing off jokes to sing a song.
A love song. There are video clips of them frolicking and playing behind. And then you fast forward.
It's domestic.
Domestic abuse. Restraining orders. motherfucker. That's hilarious.
And Piscopo comes around every once in a while and peeks his head in here.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Oh, my God.
Whatever. Good luck to you there, Joe.
He cried on Stern? Is that somebody saying?
Is there anything else in the article?
I am going to go through every one of these Channel 9 show Stern clips when I get home just for Joe Piscopo. I want to see every second of Joe Piscopo professing his love for Kimberly.
Knowing how it ended?
Yes. Knowing that it ended in restraining orders and domestic abuse.
Kimberly filed for divorce July 10th. But the couple tried to continue living together in the Piscopo mansion.
Well,
that is, until last weekend, when after one particularly ugly scene, Kimberly sought an emergency order of protection.
Kimberly.
Yeah.
They want to tear you apart.
stinks.
No one cares about how sweet it is.
I bet it's good. What's his name? The guy, the character he's playing, Joe, Jackie what?
Jack Cosmo.
Jack Cosmo.
Even the name is awful.
It's terrible.
Oh, luck. Luck for us.
What'd you find? The trailer?
All right.
This is going to be good.
All right.
Do you know what I did before this?
Yeah. You were a degenerate gambler.
Before that, I was a director.
Fancy that.
We should wear gloves when we do this.
Jack Cosmo.
I haven't been in the business in 10 years.
Jack Cosmo. Jack Cosmo.
I'm sorry. Is there something that you're trying to tell me?
I have in mind an idea for a show.
Oh, this record scratch.
This is going to be your comeback.
I got to adjust for the wind, Bob.
Is that Reynolds?
You need to get your money back.
I got plenty of money. What I don't have is entertainment.
It's like looking into the eyes of God.
You want me to write and direct an original musical using deadbeats and... criminal?
Is that or is that not a succinct summation of the situation?
Oh, yeah, what did he say? Well, yeah.
Clifton Thompson, he owes us for drugs.
First, give me $50 so I can buy crack.
Wow. This looks terrible.
Very, very, very nice thing.
I am the boss of you. I am the boss of you.
10 years ago, this guy was huge.
10 years ago, my wife didn't look like her mother.
Your father called.
You know, it'd be helpful if we can get somebody in that theater.
I bet it all works out in the end.
Helping Ricky's house with his daughter.
The estrogen, it was good, I swear.
Where's Burt Reynolds? They haven't shown Burt Reynolds.
You'd think you would show him in the trailer, right?
Hey, he's like him.
Now has a voice.
The midget's hitting someone.
Kimberly! Oh.
Your dad is writing again.
Good for him.
No, not so much. Your dad isn't doing so great. He's trying. Everyone deserves a second chance.
Here it is. Here's
second? Try again.
Third.
Higher.
Okay, he's really trying.
Here it is.
Welcome to showbiz, kid.
Oh.
What is this? Oh, how
shameless. Oh, my God.
I bet it ends with
how
the father and daughter getting back together again.
I guess they had a bad relationship, huh?
And Paul Savino. I don't see no Burt Reynolds at all. Maybe he's not in it.
How sweet it is.
They're showing the show be successful.
Yes.
They just showed you that it works.
Oh.
He fell.
It's about the journey, Jenny.
Yeah, it is about the journey. You're right, Danny.
Shit. That was hilarious.
It is about the journey.
Oh my God. Holy fuck.
I am so douche chilled out here.